EA Sports. It's in the game. Offensive performances that I'll never forget. What a game.
We are 15 miles due west of the Atlantic, nestled in downtown Jacksonville at TIAA Bank Field. Tonight, we wrap up week three with a good Monday nighter here between the New England Patriots and the Jacksonville Jaguars. It's the first weekend of autumn, and the NFL is in full swing as off we go on EA Sports. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Play action. It's Lawrence. Steps away. Pass to Ingram is tight end. And he's going to be stopped up right at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the game's first play. And it's second down now.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. Throwing again on second down, Lawrence. He targets Ingram from under ground, and he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. That one a pickup of 15 for Jacksonville.
Well, Charles, look, and this is probably a harbinger of things to come. He's got such trust in his tight end, and they're on back-to-back plays. We're seeing that on display.
And when they have that kind of trust, they're not as worried about what the coverage is because they feel like they know each other so well. They'll make the subtle move downfield, and the ball will end up in the right spot. And by the way, partner, what's harbinger mean? Help me out.
Well, you're the one that taught me that a few years ago, so I'll have to lean on you for that. I was hoping it fit into the sentence correctly.
I must have got it from my word of the day calendar on my desk.
They keep it with Henry on first down.
And a strong run there as he'll take this all the way down to the 35.
Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down. So back-to-back big runs, picking apart this defense on the opening drive.
I thought this was a passing league. I thought this was the era we were in where the ball was always in the air, right?
They didn't get the memo.
They didn't get the memo, and I know this to be true. Offensive linemen still, to this day, they want to run the football. They want to fire out and hit people across the line of scrimmage and make clearing space.
Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time, and a first down.
Pretty solid opening drive here, Charles. They've worked in the run game, the pass game, just steadily getting yards, and now they've got it inside the red zone here with an opportunity.
And the only thing they don't have so far is points. And the way they're moving the ball now, that shouldn't take much longer. And they've established a great balance so far, running, passing, doing what they want on offense.
The Jaguars at 1-1 through two games thus far.
It's not a start that's going to set the world on fire, but they've been pretty solid nonetheless.
And the first thing that crosses my mind is certainly beats the alternative of starting 0-2. I do think that this is a team that's going to take a little time to find its footing. Hard to navigate the always tough NFL.
On second down, here's Henry. 5 yards, now it's 3rd and 5.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
Eighth play of this opening drive coming up. This is 3rd down.
Look at me. Go. Go.
You can do it.
On the ball.
Let's make something.
A toss right to Henry. And he gets the first down yardage before he's brought down just outside the 10 at the 11. Able to get what they need to keep the drive going with a 6-yard pickup on 3rd down. And
had a chance to maybe limit them to three if they could have gotten that stop there, but a new set of downs.
And with a new set of downs, you got to take the mentality of the whole thing, right? And everyone's looking at the offense and saying they've got the advantage. The best defense is just okay.
And he takes it in. Touchdown, Jacksonville. Derrick Henry with his fourth rushing touchdown of the year. And the Jaguars will claim the early lead as they're on the board first here tonight. Kick this one away. And here comes a return from a few steps into the end zone. And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line. So bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision. Loses him about 4 yards.
On the way.
First carry for Damian Harris, the Alabama man. Taken down behind the line of scrimmage. A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. This defense for the Jags, much improved from week one. They were terrific last week in getting their guys their first win of the season.
And that's all. It was a nearly unstoppable pass rush. 5 sacks last week, plenty of hurries given up. So now what do you do on offense? You just max protect, keep everyone in and run the ball, or maybe just one or two receiver routes and really try to keep your quarterback upright.
Now a first down carry for Harris. And he'll get this one up to about the 39 here. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3. And they run with Harris off the option. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
Now that's the way to do it. Hand it to someone with vision and good footwork, and add in a little bit of power, and you find a way to pick up first downs.
A quick throw knocked away and incomplete.
Nice progress down the field was halted by that incompletion. They could try for some safe yards here to get things moving again, but keep throwing it and pushing it downfield to try and pick up bigger yardage.
To throw again on 2nd down. Hurts. And it's held in by Austin Hooper. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars 39. A run with Harris out of the shotgun. And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage.
Oftentimes when you see a running back get bunched up in the backfield, it's usually because the defensive tackle is eating up blockers for others to make the play. Not in this case.
Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. And he's going to be out of bounds down around the 35-yard line.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get out to your running back and it could turn into a big game downfield. What a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short game.
He's got his man, Thornton. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal. Harris running straight ahead. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. That's going to go as a loss of 1 yard, and it'll be 2nd down. After 1-7-0 on EA Sports. Second down and goal. Hurts. Touchdown, Patriots. Chase Claypool. His fourth touchdown on the year. And the Pats are an extra point away from drawing level. Extra point right down the middle. And we are tied at 7.
This is our last chance.
Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. Here comes Darius Phillips out of the end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. So both of these teams, Charles, coming off touchdowns now, but this offense, they just had to stand on the sideline, watch their opponent author a really impressive drive to reach the end zone.
Yeah, and I think you're not telling yourself the truth if you don't think there's some one-upsmanship going on right now, because they just had their touchdown answered by a drive of double-digit plays that also found the end zone. Now, they want to do something even more impressive to answer that one.
2 yards the loss, 2nd and 12.
With his size, he's a tough man to bring down, but they do a nice job there stopping his progress and not allowing him to get back to the line of scrimmage.
Off the play fake, here's Lawrence. He'll air this one out deep for Davis, and that is incomplete.
Sure, that pass was incomplete as they made an attempt to get a big one downfield. But that's okay, because the second part of that is, if you don't get the completion, at least you've told the defense you're trying to stretch them out a little bit, and they may have to change accordingly.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Here's Lawrence to throw. The Pats are going to get there. Down he goes. Brings up fourth down there, a loss of 6 yards on the sack. On fourth down, on is Logan Cook to punt. He gets us away. It's a good one, drawing toward the sidelines. And this one goes angling out of bounds, and it will be spotted inside the 30-yard line. The Pats at the line, ready to go. The offense running out, and they are charged up, ready to go after reaching the end zone on their last drive.
And normally I warn against getting complacent just because they scored the last time out, but I don't think there's any worries with this group right now. This is a hungry group, and they want to keep building off of their last drive. Now they just want the officials to hurry up and place the ball so they can snap it and get back to work.
Harris going to get it again on second down. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
2nd and 1 is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield, but I bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs and let's go get the first down. They love being physical.
They'll throw on first down with Hurts. Completes this one to Thornton. And they're going to get this down to about the 37.
Of course, the catch was nice, but how about what happened after? Able to stay on his feet and gain all that additional yardage. So many of these slot guys, I think, have running back in their background.
On first down, Hurts. No, hauled in by Smith-Schuster. And this will go as a gain of 7 as he gets it to the 30-yard line.
Able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he get a good head of steam going.
On second down, this is Harris. About 3 yards there to the 27. Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
Trying to pick it up on the ground with Harris. And just good downhill running there as he'll take this to the 15-yard line. That'll be a New England first down and gain of 12. Although his reputation as a speedy runner precedes him, it's always fun to watch him work.
It is eye-opening, isn't it? Because when you see him get the ball and just go, in addition to that speed, it helps out his blockers. They don't have to hold blocks for long because he's just going to speed right past them.
Well, he tries to keep the legs churning, but he's going to be stopped behind the line.
Well, that kind of hit will certainly fire up your team, both on the field and on the sideline. Tackles for lost yardage, they're always welcome.
On second and 12, Hurts. It's complete to Harris. And he takes it inside the 10 to the 8 before he's out of bounds. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And now it's 3rd and 3. He's already proven to be a factor in the running game on this drive. Now he gets involved in the passing game.
I think what we're seeing here is the modern version of workhorse in the NFL, being able to run it.
Looking for Thornton, he's got him. Touchdown New England. A great effort there. His first touchdown of the new season. And the Patriots have moved out in front. Point after, right down the middle. And that makes the score 14-7. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. Phillips, he's not going to bring this one out, so they will begin the drive at the 25. The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. That 7-0 lead in there is short-lived as they've now given up 2 straight touchdowns to fall behind by 7.
Yeah, but no cause for discouragement here. Yeah, they've fallen behind, but haven't they proven that they can go down and score? So what was the formula to get them down there the first time? Get back to something close to that, and maybe then get this game tied up.
Ooh, moving from his tight end spot there.
Do you think that perhaps the play call was for him?
The false start backs him up 5, first and 15. Running left, it's Henry. And he's brought down at the 24 after a gain of 4. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
We've hit the 2-minute mark of the second quarter, 14-7. A reminder coming up just a few minutes from now, we'll send you to Jonathan Coachman and our crew in Orlando. Coach will have a look back at some of the stats and scores from yesterday's action. On play action, Lawrence. Pass incomplete, but the flag in the backfield, and this might be a roughing call. So roughing the passer, and they get the safety there.
And this is one I think where the safety's usually got to come a long way. So sometimes it's tough for them to slow down that momentum. That's going to draw the flag more times than not.
So now a fresh set of downs, 1st and 10 after roughing the passer. After the penalty, it's Henry. Treads him with a stiff arm. And some nifty running here as he'll take this across midfield and down to the 47. 63 yards for him on the ground so far tonight as he has been terrific in this first half. On 1st down, Lawrence. And the pass is intercepted. He was looking for Ingram. It's Kyler Dugger who picks it. And the Pats are going to take over a couple of yards shy of midfield.
And that's a great example of ball skills right there, partner. You and I do a lot of games, and I can't tell you how many guys look to run with the football before they've intercepted it. So that's a nice job of focusing on the task at hand and coming away with the interception.
He's going to sling this deep downfield. All wide open, complete. And all the way in. Touchdown. Chase Claypool with his 2nd touchdown of the game and 5th on the year. And the Patriots are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. The point after is good, and it's now 21-7. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. Phillips now for the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And Charles, we'll see what they can do here. Not a ton of time left, but enough certainly to get points out of this drive. And nowhere to go here. He lost the football. But it looked like a Jaguar was able to cover this thing, and so Jacksonville will keep control.
Much like a running back going through the line, quarterbacks have to be aware of protecting the football as well. He left it exposed that time, wound up having it knocked free, but fortunately had an alert teammate who was able to get it.
And he'll protect himself at the end here as he winds up getting pretty decent yardage. The Jaguars going to go ahead and use their first timeout as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half.
Come on,
an extra corner comes on now for the Patriots D on third down.
Recon, 132 fighter. Hey, Delta. Hey, Delta.
Here's Lawrence. He rifles one that's intercepted. An unfortunate sequence there, trying to get points before intermission, but now the interception, and their opponents have a chance to possibly pad their lead.
Yeah, they had an opportunity there, and they weren't able to capitalize on it, and that's something that could come back and haunt them later. They're begging their defense now to keep them from scoring before the half ends.
On the move to his left. He's got a man complete. Now the Patriots going to use one of their timeouts as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in the first half of play. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. Gets it quickly out wide to Thornton. So give him 2 yards there on the completion, and it'll be second down.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
From the 16, Hurts. Touchdown! Chase Claypool. On his way to a monster game. 3 first half touchdowns. And the Patriots will extend their lead in the final minute of the half. The extra point up and good. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. Phillips now from the end zone. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. And the ball backed way up. So thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it, and we'll see these two teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball. Just go ahead and finish up the half and get on out and talk about it.
So we are at halftime here on a Monday night. As we send you a couple hours south of here to Orlando, that's where we check in with a coach at our EA Sports Halftime Report. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Glenn, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. So here we go for half number two. The Patriots with the lead, and they will be getting the football. And this is going to be returned from the middle of the end zone. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. The Pats at the line, ready to go. Well, this offense, this team, they are rolling right now, Charles. They've scored on 3 straight possessions. You look at the scoreboard, and they pretty much right now got this thing on cruise control.
Yeah, and this is that time of game where you and I have to be prepared, right? Isn't this kind of like that empty the bucket time where you have to go into your blowout material and make sure we have some different things? That's what we're staring at right now, the way this one is going.
He gets 12 on the keeper there, but now it's third down.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they are playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time and making it work.
Now flags come in. Looked like one of the Patriots might have moved.
Okay, ready?
Well, that's a tough, costly penalty because now it makes it third and six after the false start.
19 tight. Ready?
Here's Hurts to throw. Oh, he rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Miles Jack. And the Jags are going to take possession of the football. But pretty much everything went their way offensively in the first half, but now an interception on the opening drive of the third quarter.
As we know, the key to everything here, don't get careless with the football. The problem is you've got to stay aggressive as well. So where's the line between being aggressive and attacking and being overly aggressive? I think they just crossed it on that one.
70 yards for him on the ground now. He has been a tough man to bring down all night. A good run, got seven on first. Here's second and three. 10th carry now for Derrick Henry. And that one blown up quickly as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. That's a big loss of three, and it brings up third down. They'll need five on this play to move the sticks. And a dangerous throw there as that's knocked down and incomplete.
You get the sense that they're saying we're not playing up to what we're capable of, and we're deep enough into the game that the early jitters are long gone, that they should now have some sense of continuity and be able to make some of these plays that they have not been doing so far. Yeah, we can make this one pretty simple, partner. You always want to end drives with points, but that's one that you're going to look back on and probably say we should have done better there.
And they will be backed up deep. Trouble here as they're going to start this drive at the six.
Anytime you field a kickoff inside your own end zone, you've got to be decisive about whether you're bringing it out or not. Sometimes that indecision can really cost you. That may have been what happened on that play.
They turn to Harris to begin the drive, and he is going to lose yardage here. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
I think it's pretty evident we can say what a difference a week makes. Last week, he ran pretty much wild, didn't he? Did pretty much what he wanted to do. But this one, they've stopped him cold. That, to me, that's good scouting and even better execution.
Yeah, and they stopped him behind the line right there. They obviously watched the tape a few times and made some adjustments. A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
Well, you know me, whether you need it or not, I'm going to give a little unsolicited advice. Just throw it downfield out of the pocket only if you're absolutely sure. Otherwise, use your running ability and try and get those yards a safer way.
They'd like to avoid punting from their own end zone so they could use something here on third down. Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts. Yeah, this pass broken up. Excellent coverage there on third down, as that was not an easy one to hold on to. The Patriots send out their punter. And no room for error here as his first punt comes from deep in his own end zone. It's taken to the 26. A very good return there. Give him an even 20 yards. And the Jaguars go on offense, first down and 10. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get two more possessions.
So the big play gets them all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. Again, it's Henry. And he will be brought down at about the 6 yard line. That one goes for 16 yards. It sets him up first and goal.
Hey, stand up!
They'll try one for Henry. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. And That's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
With his size, it often takes more than one guy to get him down, but if you can at least slow him up and the reinforcements arrive, you have a chance to get him on the ground, and that they did that time for a loss.
Block it, block it.
The handoff running left, Henry. And he will get this into the end zone for a Jaguar touchdown. Derrick Henry, his second touchdown of the night. And the Jaguars get a bit closer. Extra point splits the offense. And the lead is down to 11 at 28-17. After the touchdown, Cook now to kick this one away. And we'll see a return here from the end zone. At the line, ready to go. Their lead down to two scores after the touchdown a moment ago as they start with a first and 10. He is taken down at the 21 after a short gain of 2.
Well, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
And let's face it, you can put any Halloween costume on and you're not going to be able to disguise him, because for a tight end of his size, difficult to sneak him anywhere, but that's what they tried to do. Lined up on his right, tried to work his way back to his left, but just a minimal gain as the defense was able to react quickly.
He's got a man open. It's Chase Claypool. And he will have a Patriots first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
We use the term pitch and catch a lot to denote an easy completion. We just saw one right there on 3rd and 3 to pick up the first down.
Why are those so tough to defend? Just because they hit so quickly?
Yeah, it's all about timing and confidence. Quarterback sees it, rips it, there you go.
They run the option here on 1st and 10. And he goes out right around the 39. Give him 4 yards there on the first down keeper.
Well, if you're going to run the read option, typically, you've got to keep an eye on the defensive end.
And what does that mean? What are you looking for with a defensive end?
Well, you want to play off of what he does. If he collapses inside towards the running back, then you pull it and take it yourself outside in. If he stays outside, you go ahead and leave it with the running back. In this case, pulled it and got good yardage himself.
They hand this off to Harris. And able to get a couple as he's across the 40 to the 41.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is to have your linebackers set the edge.
Hurts. And this pass broken up. Patriots send out their punter as he'll punt it away for the second time. And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. And this is going to carry well into the end zone for a touchback. Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. And here we are almost through 3 quarters of play, and this passing game still has not really found any kind of rhythm.
Put it mildly, because they're not even over 100 yards yet. And in today's NFL, where it's a pass-first league, that is quite surprising. Not many teams patient enough to stick with the run. Everybody wants to advance the ball through the air. They've got to get their timing back.
He continues to have a big night here under the lights carrying the football.
And some guys prefer night games. For whatever reason, their bodies react a certain way. They love the spotlight. Maybe that's what it is. The best seats in the house, the ones where he's carrying the football for his offensive teammates. The worst seats, the 11 guys trying to tackle him on defense.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. And a busy night for Henry continues. One quarter remains here as we wrap up the week on a Monday night. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. The offense on third down tonight, they've only converted once in four tries. This is third and seven. Now Lawrence to throw. Complete. Smith has it. And he'll only get this to about the 44 as they stop him short of the line to gain. So 5 yards here, five on the play. And it'll be fourth down.
I thought maybe when he caught, he'd have a good chance of getting that first down, but that's a nice job holding him up and preventing him from getting to the sticks.
They'll run. It's Henry. Some chances you might not normally take, and here that one pays off big time.
And you have to think to yourself, not only did that pay off big time for them, but what was going on the opposite side of the ball? They know that they have to take a chance here. They know they have to come up with something big, yet it still happened. So credit the execution, but wonder what the defense was doing.
They'll try to run it in with Henry. And after the good game last play, this time they say, uh-oh, as he's going to be stopped behind the line of scrimmage. After the touchdown, Cook now to kick this one away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. The Pats at the line, ready to go. They've been asleep for a little while on this side of the football, Charles, and the score is just a one-score game now. Haven't had any points this half. What gives?
Let's go old school here. All right, let's get back to the basics. Get back to running the football. High percentage throws. Find the guys that eat pressure and make plays for you and make sure they touch it.
From the 27, Hurts. They're fighting Thornton over the middle. Good for a gain of six, and this will wind up being a third and three. Right there, he rose to the occasion late in a close game.
It's something he thought about, dreamed about, and worked on throughout his career, because in these types of situations, he wasn't going to allow extra coverage to keep him from getting the football.
From the gun, it's Hurts. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by Von Bell, and the Jaguars are right back in this football game. A seismic shift in momentum here in the fourth quarter. That's the break that the defense needed.
And you know as well as I do, people are going to question the play call in that situation. Sometimes you have to question the execution, not necessarily the call. And in this case, those defenders found a way to give their team a chance.
Up near the 45 at the 44. And give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six.
Brandon, we just saw the benefits of being able to run the ball successfully. They pick up 4 yards on that carry. So now if you're a play caller, you can do just about anything you want. But on the defensive side of the ball, you scramble a little bit. Now you're behind trying to figure out, do I need to blitz him? Do I need to pressure him? How do I gain an advantage on this snap?
Henry again on second down. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. With 208 yards on the ground for him now as he has gotten better, really, as the night's gone on.
Another tackle leader and a good one. It's crunch time.
continue to be productive in both the run and passing game in order for them to try and snatch a victory.
A first down carry for Henry. And they'll get this just to the 47, 1 yard gain.
Well, for an inside linebacker, I think you'd agree when I say that he is fast to the football, and he proved that thesis correct on that last play.
And sometimes all of your best laid plans of play design, your X's and O's, they can't always account for individual effort defensively. And this was one of those times. Just a terrific play to hustle over there and get the running back to the ground.
And his top speed, as computed by Next Gen Stats, not bad. He was pushing 20 miles an hour.
Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run. And now they'll throw it with Lawrence. And now this one may draw a penalty. He just blindly threw that one to the sideline. And yep, indeed, the flag is out.
That was terrible.
Every penalty so critical at this stage of the game, as now they've got it third and long.
Take it to him.
Now Lawrence. Lawrence hit and the ball is free. Second time in this game, Charles, the ball is squirted out from his hands. Luckily, his teammate was there to pounce on it.
You're right. Got the lucky bounce, able to retain possession. You know, we often talk about the combine and why do we measure quarterbacks' hands. Is that really a big deal? It's for situations like this. Do you have the hands big enough and strong enough to hold on to the football while being jostled?
A Cook now on to punt as he gets this one away.
And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line. The Pats at the line, ready to go. And now clinging to a one-score lead, Charles, and I think operating within that four-minute offense with a little less than 4 minutes to go applies here, right?
It certainly does, and that means the playbook is still wide open. But you are a little bit more careful about what you're calling. You want plays that are going to gain yardage, how would you say, consistently, right? You don't need the big shots downfield, but make sure the clock continues to run. Pile up the first downs, and the goal, end the game with your quarterback kneeling down at the end, and you still have the lead.
Josh Allen able to get him for a loss of about three. Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. Hurts sets up to throw it. Open man, Smith-Schuster, it's complete. And they work this well upfield across the 45. That's a third down conversion to 24 yards there. Nice play. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. On the give, this is Harris. And he's going to take this across midfield into Jacksonville territory. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
Well, they picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play real effect. Let the clock wind down.
Harris on second down. Now he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. After that run, still a good amount of meat on the bone here for this third down play. Can you envision them putting this in the air?
Totally. I mean, look at who he has under center right now. If you can't trust him with the football, you can't trust anyone. And frankly, to me, I want the ball down the stretch. Get the first down. Keep it in the hands of my offense. I don't want to turn it over to them and rely on my D.
From the midfield stripe, they look to throw. And he'll be brought down on the other side of midfield at the 43.
Now that's a killer, because you think you got it absolutely covered, and then he puts it out of there and picks up a first down. Drives you crazy as a defense.
Looks like you're exactly right. Looked like a for sure stop on third, and then the tables turn. Harris, and he edges forward, but only gets a pair of yards out of it, and it's second down. Now a second timeout called for by the defense, as the clock will stop with just under 30 seconds left to go. This, in all probability, another run here on second and eight. The Patriots in the victory formation as they'll take the knee. The line to gain is the 33 on third down. The Jaguars now will use the last of their timeouts. It'll be their third and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside.
They'll come to the line here needing 9 yards to pick up the first.
And they'll indeed take a knee. So this will wind up a victory for the New England Patriots.